Rocco, come here with this camera, please. Get a close-up of up here. This is me up here.
That's me.
This is me.
That's me.
All right, humble, not a madman like the mad monk over here.
Rasputin, is that who you're trying to think
of? That's exactly who I'm talking about. Them people watching know that we're talking about Rasputin, the mad monk.
Actually, that's more like me. Bowl of pea soup,
you're out
slice
of your
of
fucking
bread,
mind.
Bible, saying my prayers.
Yeah, you have a lot of wants and fucking theories, but they're all fucking horse shit out of
Fuck
your
you.
Ass.
Sometimes called Patsy because my real name is Pasquale, which is Italian. But when I went to school, the Irish nuns, I'd be writing Patsy. They'd say, they'd hit my hand with the big steel ruler. You write Patrick. Well, you know, my name now is Patrick on stuff, but really I was born Pasquale. Hung around with another guy that might have been Arabic. His name was Jim Cadio. I was coming from a girlfriend's house. I seen Cadio with his head all swathed in bandages. I thought maybe he was, well, living up to his Arab background. And I said to somebody, what happened to him? They said, Pee Wee the Puerto Rican did a number on him for fucking with his bowling ball and shoes.
Anyway, there's stories that go on and on. We can go on for weeks with the stories of growing up in that rough environment.
Crazy part of it is, I mean, these guys are going to be 62 in May, end of May, before Memorial Day. And I'll be 72 in October. Most of the people we don't are dead.
He used to say, I'm here for the good time, not the long time. And as it is, they're gone.
Hold the pickles, hold the lettuce. Special orders don't upset us. All we ask is that you let us have it your way. Have it your way. At Burger King. Have it your way. And then you know what McDonald's famous little slogan was?
Yeah.
Do you know what it is? McDonald's is your kind of place. Hamburgers in your face. Pickles up your nose. French fries between your toes. And don't forget those delicious shakes. They come from polluted lakes. McDonald's is your kind of place.
My wife says I'm two kinds of good.
Oh, Jesus.
What do you think of that?
What do you mean exactly?
She says I'm two kinds of good. No good and good for nothing.
I hit seventh grade. And then when I hit eighth grade, the first day on my ride home, this girl sat down next to me. And I said, there's other seats. Please move. She refused. All right? And she'd sit with me every day until I became attracted to her. And then as soon as I showed some interest in her, of course I was attracted from the beginning. I just, you know, that's what guys do, they reject. As soon as I showed some interest, then she moved on. And she broke my heart for the next 4 years until I actually started going out with her and I eventually married her. And then we moved up on the hill and then we had six kids and here I am today.
My father. He's a good shit. Love him to death. Like I always say, I could have asked for richer parents, but not better parents.
My Hannah has left with a boy. And we're nervous.
Not because of the reasons you think.
Because he's driving. And you think we're going to follow her. And we're going to follow her. No, but you're not nervous about her.
What?
It's not only the pregnancy issue.
The carefully bags. The Bob's carefully bags are that's the STD thing.
What? A condom?
That protects a lot.
And what else? There's all the oral stuff.
Am I proud of my kids?
Yeah. I wouldn't change them. Well, the few things I'd change, but I wouldn't make radical changes. I think they're good kids. Are you proud of my kids?
No, Eric's trying to make me talk about stuff and he hasn't quite hit on anything worth talking about. He's trying to get my political viewpoints.
Oh, gosh. Do you have any?
Yeah, I have. Mostly we're picking on the film guy.
Oh.
He's being outsmarted by his camera quite a bit. Well, I went to work one day, and it was Saturday. And the secretaries were off on Saturdays.
Well, this guys is MIT. Are,
well, one of the guys was Ron McNair, who was the astronaut who died on the Challenger.
Yeah, he was there.
He was there, and they're all standing around trying to. They're all there with screwdrivers and meters.
Because the coffee maker didn't turn on.
They couldn't turn on the coffee maker. And I'm standing, I said, they're going to ruin our coffee maker. I said, so I walked over, and I just looked over their shoulder, and I said, excuse me. I reached in, I hit the on button, and turned on and walked away. They just didn't turn it
the
on.
The astronaut, the scientist, the fusion expert. They're all
yeah, they're all
there.
Standing around. There's a cluster of them.
Nobody knew how to make the coffee work.
I met George back in 1980. We got married in 87. So we dated off and on for 7 years. He's always been good. He's always been a good father for the kids. And always did stuff with all you guys, as you know, because I mean, he did the soccer, he did whatever with you guys. He always did everything. So.
That's about it. Yeah. It's a good guy to be married to. After 25 years of marriage, I still like him. So.
I am very happy. I have a great life.
That's it? That's the cliffhanger.
We've had this conversation before. You asked me if I was happy. I said, of course I'm happy. Yeah. I have a great wife. I have a great family. I live in a terrific location. It's everything I ever wanted.
What the hell is this?
Channel 6.
I'll tell you what. Rocco, how you doing, buddy?
I'm
this
good.
This is what I call Psychedelic Sunday on a Saturday afternoon. Okay, this is the first lesson. You can't fool an old fool, but you can fuck a dummy. I know I fucked a couple. You want to see the garage?
Yeah.
All right, let's go to the garage. This is where I do most of my work. Of course, you gotta have a stereo. Grinders. Couple old dirt bikes over there. I've had them since I've been dirt riding, 30 years or so. They still run. Of course, we got our Harley over here. We gotta have that. I've been riding that baby for 34 years. Been a while. The next
thing you know, boy. Howdy, neighbor. Boy, I've lived here for about 34 years. I bought the place in 78. It was colder than a witch's tit, so I didn't move in. I got here in the spring of 79, and I've lived here alone for 17 years and had nothing but parties. But them days are over. Michael rolled along, and I was done.
Like I told you, I was born in a DP camp, which is a displaced persons camp is what they call it. In fact, 6 of us were born there in Austria. And we got out of there, we got to New York City, a sponsor took us, we got to Athens, and I grew up in Athens. That's where I learned from tape players too, is Vietnam. Everybody had a tape player over there. Tapes were big when we were in Vietnam. All right.
Politicians, I mean, people like us aren't crooked. We're born to be crooked.
Be politically correct. We're out of
anyway.
Liberal school. This is going to go all the way to Obama.
So Donald, what exactly is the situation right now?
You're a jackass.
So what do you want?
I will eat
for dinner.
Now that was a ball. I went there. I had a lot of fun at Woodstock. I got to admit that.